In labs across Asia and Europe, engineers have trained robots to shave human faces safely. Using sensors so precise, they can detect a hair's thickness. They learn from human demonstration videos, then refine their grip through tactile feedback loops, pressure, heat, resistance. It's not just a stunt, it's a test of empathy. Because to shave someone safely, the robot must understand pain without ever feeling it.
The AI learns through imitation and reinforcement, just like a child watching their parent. One wrong move, and it's disaster. But it doesn't make mistakes anymore.
It feels the angle, pressure, vibration. It adjusts in real time. A few years ago, that would have been impossible. That's the difference between automation and awareness. A machine that can hold a pen, balance pressure, and form perfect letters. Sounds harmless, right? But the deeper story is about fine motor control and memory. The robot learns to reproduce human handwriting by analyzing thousands of motion patterns. Each letter becomes a mathematical shape, every curve a precise data point. And soon, it's writing better than the human who taught it. This isn't imitation, it's optimization. Riding a bicycle is one of the hardest human skills to simulate. It's physics, balance, intuition, and micro-adjustments. But robots are now doing it effortlessly. Using deep reinforcement learning, they calculate how to shift weight, counter gravity, and recover from slips in milliseconds. And then there's the bottle flip challenge, a silly human trend now mastered by AI robots that simulate thousands of flips per second until they land every single one. These robots aren't just learning what to do, they're learning how to play. Now imagine your home, a robot that can vacuum, cook, fold laundry, hand you a towel, or help your grandparents walk. That's not the future, it's happening now. Companies in Japan, China, and the US are creating robots designed for elderly care, companionship, and daily support. Then came movement, the final frontier. For decades, walking was the ultimate challenge. Now, robots don't just walk, they run, they leap, they fall, and get back up. With real-time balance algorithms and AI-powered muscle simulations, they navigate terrain humans would hesitate to cross. It's parkour, precision, and persistence, all powered by code. And every new movement brings them closer to something that once seemed impossible: instinct. But here's the question. What are they really learning? Shaving, riding, running. These are just skills. But beneath the surface, they're learning adaptation, anticipation, autonomy. But here's the question. When machines learn everything we do, faster, safer, and without fear, what's left for us? Because they don't sleep, they don't forget, they don't stop improving. And soon, the only thing separating us from them might be the emotion behind the motion. The same algorithms that let a robot learn to shave can teach another to fire a weapon. Technology is neutral. The question is, are we? Those same robots that were learning to make breakfast are now being trained for war. Robotic dogs are already on the battlefield, deployed in Ukraine, armed, autonomous, able to track, move, and eliminate targets faster than any soldier could react. These machines, once built for companionship and rescue, are now learning to kill. And it doesn't stop there. The US military has already signed contracts with OpenAI and XAI, exploring artificial intelligence for defense and combat decision-making. Think about that. The same technology writing poetry and designing apps could soon be deciding who lives and who dies. AI doesn't hesitate. It doesn't feel guilt. It just executes orders. The same hands that built robots to pour tea are now teaching them to pull triggers. The same minds that trained them to be gentle as a lamb are now forging them into perfect military killers. This is the paradox of progress. Every leap forward comes with a shadow. Every great invention changes the world twice. First, when it's created, and again, when we see what it becomes.